Welcome, Yomi. So, fourth day. Still India ahead, right?
Definitely. Advantage is with India. Great comeback from the bowlers, especially in the last session. 100, 104 for 4, I think India should be able to win.
Yeah, and on the wicket rate, generally day 4 and day 5, it's normally deteriorates a lot, but since the inception of the drop in wickets in Australia, I always felt that the first innings batsmen are struggling, and as and when the test match goes right, it is not deterring as much. So 104 for 4, definitely poor batting by Australia, right?
Yeah, like I would say that they were probably a bit negative, as in they are not getting their momentum, they are not getting a move on, they were confined in a shell, not looking to put away the bad balls, or not showing that intent. If they probably showed that intent, then probably India would have been a bit more on the back foot. It's not a big lead, 320 is the target. So I'm sure if they had probably shown a better intent, they would have been in a better position.
As such, there wasn't too much of bad balls from India. So, but at this level, at least at test level, you must be able to at least rotate the strike even of good balls, right? Because great teams, in fact, decent enough test batsmen have this knack of turning the strike over of good balls. But I feel this Australian lineup is waiting for the loose balls to score boundaries. So, is that a correct assessment by me?
Definitely, they have to look to rotate the strike. But that's where the experience comes in. That's where they're probably missing out Smith or Warner, where they've been in this situation and they know how to handle the situation. Definitely, experience plays a big role here.
And now we can clearly see the impact of Warner and Smith, right? Because almost they are minus 200, when you combine two innings together. So that is four innings, right? So almost 150, 200 runs minus. So it puts added pressure on the batsmen. The one advantage with Smith and Warner in the team is, right, all the plans, all the thought process from the opposition bowlers will be on those two. So that is when the other batsmen cash in. So, but now it is not that case. So definitely they are feeling that, they are not in the side.
Sure, definitely they are missing out Smith and Warner. The impact that these two batsmen create on the opponent bowler is—it's a totally different thing. I mean, they are top quality batsmen, and they even good ball seems to be a bad ball for them, and that sort of caliber both are in. So definitely they are missing out.
Yeah, and not to take away any credit from Indian bowlers, but still this is a very inexperienced batting lineup. But still, India have to do whatever is thrown at them, and they have done very well. Especially, I thought the consistency that the fast bowlers have had in this test match, it was incredible. Because I mean, all these years when India travelled to Australia, either they were too short and too wide, right? So for that, batsmen can play those horizontal shots. And over a period of time, they used to let the pressure go off by bowling bad balls here and there. But this test match, at least, they are very, very tight in their lines and lengths, right?
Yeah, they definitely got the length perfect. I mean, if you actually see, except for Bumrah, the other fast bowlers have already toured here. This is probably the second or third tour. And they have learnt a lot. And the glaring thing that I can say is that the fact that their length has been perfect and their lines have been really immaculate, causing a lot of pressure for the batsman.
And what did you think of Lyons bowling? Because he got a lot of wickets today morning. So he's come a long way, right? I mean, 2-3 years back, his place was always in a controversial situation where he was the best spinner or not. But last 2 years or so, he's been almost the number one spinner in the country, and in fact in the world he must be in the top 2 or 3, right? So his performance,
surely he's the one who's brought the game back to Australia. I mean, they probably would have looked at around 400, 450 the lead, but he brought them back into the game, and credit to him for the pulling back the game.
And why do you think he's successful, Yomi? Because when you see on television, right, it is, there's no dusra, tisra, whatever variations that he's going to try. Just going to bowl that off spin, outside off stump. He has fielders on the leg side. We all know that what he's going to do, but still he's successful. And why do you think so?
It's because of the consistency. And his, he gets that bounce. He gets that, because of his action, more of side on. And then he goes over the top of the ball and, you know, lands it. He dips the ball. The ball dips in front of the batsman. That's a big advantage for him. And that's a very, you know, fine skill that needs, that not many bowlers have these days. They are more, you know, varying the pace, you know, bowling a bit faster, trying to, you know, bowl fast and beat the batsman. But he's more, you know,
gets
more revs on the ball, and because of that revs, he gets that bounce on the wicket. So that's a great skill these days.
Yeah, and what did you think of India's batting lineup? Yes, India are in a good position, but do you think that the 3, 4 and 5, right, Rahane, Pujara and Kohli, apart from that, there isn't too much runs at the top as well as at the bottom, right? So do you think that is a concern going forward in this series?
I won't say it's a concern, but the thing is, if you see in the positive, almost everyone has had a good knock in this match, except for MVJ. But what I would probably say is that the lower order can, you know, contribute a bit more. That makes a big difference in stamping of authority on the game. If you had probably, you know, given them a target of 400 or 450, they would have been out of the game already. But you still, you know, gave them a chance of coming in. Yes, they did lose 4 wickets at the end of the day. But against a very good team, you should probably look to, you know, so finish them off there itself and not let them come up.
Yomi, coming to the no balls, right? There was one incident today that Finch was given out first over, and finally when they saw, Finch actually took a review for, you know, he was thinking the ball might go down the leg side. He took that DRS, and it was seen that, you know, Ishan Sharma had overstepped. And there are few balls after that as well where Ishan Sharma was close enough, and in fact it could have been called a no ball. So are we coming to a stage where, you know, if there is only a wicket falls and then the umpire goes and, you know, checks for the no ball? Say for example, Australia could have had 3 or 4 runs more, and you never know how many bowlers are, you know, bowling those no balls. So do you think that the line decision, the no ball decision, should automatically go to the third umpire, and the main umpire can focus on what's happening at the other end?
Yeah, I believe. You know, in such a, you know, really tough series, you know, very, very important series, these small, you know, errors made by, you know, umpires can go a long way in deciding the series. But I think, you know, definitely the third umpire can, you know, take that responsibility of, you know, checking for no balls, every ball. So now you can see that the on-field umpire is, you know, probably little lazy on trying to, you know, see if he's bowling a no ball or not. It was evident in this innings. I think the third umpire can jump in and probably, you know, help the main on-field umpire to see if there is a no ball or not.
Yomi, where do you think that this test match is heading, and do you see any fight from Australia tomorrow? Will they even get close to India's total, or will India just come and, you know, pick those wickets early in the day?
Yeah, I'm sure Australia, they will go. They will definitely put up a fight tomorrow. I mean, Sean Marsh and Head, both, you know, they are pretty decent, good batsmen, and India can't take them lightly. But saying that, with that being so much of pressure on the batsmen, I'm sure India bowlers will, you know, will make sure that they get all the wickets and win the match.
India started as favourites to win the Test series in Australia, and they are well on their way to winning the first test at Adelaide Oval. That's it from us here on Crick Voice. We'll see tomorrow for the final day's play.